Well, for starters, our parents were born and raised in Mexico, I'm sure you could tell. I'm actually serious. Our parents were both born and raised in Mexico, horse and buggy, Mennonite, like no electricity, the whole nine yards. Unfortunately, our grandpa bought a truck, so they got kicked out of the colony.
Oh dear.
It had an electric ignition.
They really honestly did get kicked out for buying a truck, and they drove from Mexico all the way through the beautiful United States up to northern Alberta, Canada. So we're from way up east of Juneau, Alaska. So if you've watched Ice Road Truckers or anything crazy like that, we're really from way, way, way up there. So this is like tropical. This is like summer for us. Feels great. But we kind of missed, we never had radio or TV or anything growing up. When I turned 13, we got a TV and we were allowed to watch Fox and the Hound and Lion King, which is pretty good for a teenager. So it was pretty cool. But Curtis kind of went off
Anna
the deep
Green
end.
Gables.
Our parents were so old school that when we started listening to like more current music, what we thought was current, Mom got a little worried. Curtis was like had a Discman and was rocking out.
When I was probably like 15 already. I had a Discman and Mom was worried about what I was listening to because she couldn't hear it, obviously. So she's like, hey, what are you listening to these days? I just want to make sure it's still appropriate and I want to make sure you're not listening to anything bad. And
I think with like electric guitars.
She like, if it has distortion, it's like bad, you know? So I was like, all right, I'll play the heaviest thing I have right now. Played her sister Hazel, and I don't know
her name,
but, and she was like, I don't know.
True story for me.
And
dad was into it though.
Dad was driving. We were going down the highway, and we look over at Dad, and he's doing what we call Mennonite moshing, he's sitting there going like this, which is a symbol of. Deep admiration for
whatever
he's hearing.
But her dad really loves something, that's what he does. So thankfully they did.
The rhythm's gonna get him.
Yeah.
What's that? Yeah. But we don't have any distortion in the room today.
So we should
just
be
to honor our parents.
Don't send that to our mom, whatever you do. We just want to be careful. For real, they fell in love with country music. They really did. They drove all the way down to Nashville for their honeymoon. And they went to the Opry and saw Ricky Skaggs and many years later, just a couple months ago, they got to come and see us play the Opry for the first time together with Ricky Skaggs, and we played this song, which is our last song for you and our first song for you at the same time, because it's our first
what
single.
What a coincidence.
Oh my God, how did you set it up that way?
It's a great song.
That is so sweet.
We did some math and stuff before you got here. So,
this is Make You Mine.
One, two, three, four. You were made to shine under the southern stars. You were as a lamp to the rain. You're the love song pouring out this guitar, sweeter than sugar cane. Got my heart. I'm gonna make you mine. my arms tonight. I can